Hello and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Soukaina and I am an engineer living in Paris. Today's video is part of a series of videos about dopamine detox. I am trying this new format of content because first, I've been told that my videos are too long, so I'm taking this into consideration. And second, this topic is pretty complicated and I have a lot to say to fit in one short video. When available, all the videos will be linked in the description box. With that being said, let's get to it. If you ask people to choose whether to get $100 now or $200 in 2 weeks, most people will choose to get the $100 now. Our brain, since it has been living in survival mode for centuries, would rather have a short-term small pleasure than a long-term big one. So what makes us long for activities with instant gratification, even when they're not the best choice for us? One of the factors responsible for this is dopamine. Dopamine is a neurotransmitter released when your brain is expecting a reward. It is responsible for the feeling of desire and motivation that drive us to do something where pleasure is expected. It could be a certain food you like, shopping, sex, video games, or anything that you enjoy. When you associate a given activity with pleasure, just the anticipation is enough to raise your dopamine levels. Some people mistakenly associate dopamine with pleasure after the enjoyable act. While this is wrong, dopamine is released before the act when the brain is waiting for the reward. The role of dopamine is the anticipation and the pursuit of happiness, not happiness itself. For instance, if you love donuts like me, your brain will release dopamine when you smell them baking or when you walk by a donut shop to push you to eat them. And when you experience the pleasure of a donut, dopamine acts to reinforce this craving and make it even more appealing in the future. Therefore, your brain assumes this is a reward and encourages you to repeat this behavior, even though the food might not be the healthiest choice for your body. And that's what we call the reward cycle. Motivation, reward, reinforcement. The amount of dopamine released by the brain depends on how fast you get the reward and how much effort it takes to get it. The faster, the easier, and the less challenging the reward is, the more dopamine your brain will release. Some substances such as nicotine and alcohol activate the reward cycle. They cause a quicker and far more intense release of dopamine than what you'd get with those donuts. So you're left wanting more and soon. When you experience recurrent dopamine rushes, your brain responds by decreasing its sensibility to dopamine. Now you need more to get to that same level of pleasure. This also affects dopamine receptors in a way that makes you lose interest in everything that provides less or delayed pleasure, such as reading, working, or studying. And as I said in a previous video about coffee, the same dose of caffeine that used to make you feel alert and energetic when you first started drinking coffee will no longer give you the same effect. Because your brain adapts to regular consumption of caffeine, so you'll have to increase the dose over time to get the same effects. And when a desire for something becomes more of a need than a want, then this is addiction. So trying to stop becomes really hard because your brain is used to high levels of dopamine. Addiction is not limited to substances and drugs. It can also be to activities that provide instant gratification with so little effort, such as binge watching, scrolling social media, playing video games, watching porn, or gambling. These activities trigger high dopamine level, which results in excitement that motivates us to continue the activity, which can potentially lead to addiction. Many companies spend millions of dollars on research that exploits this reward system to keep us using their products repeatedly. Tech companies in particular understand what causes dopamine surge in the brain, and they design their product in a way that gives you little, irregularly timed rewards, so you keep coming back for more. And this is backed up by research done by the American psychologist B.F. Skinner, who found that the strongest way to reinforce a behavior in a rat is to reward it on a random schedule. It's not a coincidence that Instagram counts like, that notifications are red, and that video games have ranking systems. It's all designed so you keep checking the app because you never know when that hit of dopamine will come. The problem is when you indulge too much in dopamine-inducing activities, sitting down and working for hours become terribly boring and impossible because it releases less dopamine. To correct this and trick your brain to like such activities, many people have tried dopamine detox or dopamine fasting, which is the topic of my next video. If you enjoyed this video, please like and share it. Consider subscribing for more videos every week. And as always, guys, if you made it so far, thank you so much for watching. Question everything, do your own research, and follow your instincts. I'll see you very soon in the next video. Bye!